bye-bye. Those are President Trump's exact words. Trump walking out of a meeting with congressional leaders about the shutdown when he didn't get his way late today. And the president walking out set the tone. Both sides addressing reporters afterwards with two very different versions of what went down.
It wasn't even a high-stake negotiation. It was a petulant president of the United States.
We saw a temper tantrum because he couldn't get his way.
I saw Schumer continue to raise his voice.
I thought the president was very calm.
As for the president, he saved his version of the meeting for Twitter. Quote, just left a meeting with Chuck and Nancy, a total waste of time. I asked what's going to happen in 30 days if I quickly open things up. Are you going to approve border security, which includes a wall or steel barrier? Nancy said no. I said, bye-bye. Nothing else works. The problem is that the person at the center of a negotiation, when the outcome is whether his government reopens, can't just say bye-bye. Trump has the lead. I mean, just listen to Donald J. Trump on October 7th, 2013, talking about President Obama during a government shutdown.
You have to get everybody in a room. You have to be a leader. The president has to lead. He's got to get Mr. Boehner and everybody else in a room, and they have to make a deal.
Well, according to his own standards, Trump failed today. And while his minions are making the case for a crisis along the southern border to justify the boss's wall.
Crisis.
Well, there is a crisis tonight, just not the one they're talking about. I mean, 800,000 federal workers haven't been paid for 18 days. It's not about whether they'll get paid eventually. I mean, think about this. According to Politico, at least 4,800 federal employees and contractors in the Washington, D.C. area have applied for unemployment benefits. A spokeswoman for USAA, a federal savings bank, tells us thousands have reached out for help because they're going to miss a mortgage payment, a car loan. Some of them can't even pay their utility bills. FDA employees tell CNN that the shutdown could cost lives because crucial medical trials, you know, that have to happen, people who have tried every possible drug, right, then they get this life-saving chance to go on a trial. Well, that can't happen now. And yet the president today says that all these people are going to be happy.
Mr. President, what do you say to those federal workers, security guards, Secret Service agents, TSA agents, who are now going without pay?
I think they have been terrific. These are terrific patriots. A lot of them agree with what I'm doing, and I hope we're going to have the situation worked out.
But these people have to go without their paychecks. Some are being forced to work without pay. Some have been furloughed. These are
park rangers. They all get the money. They're all going to get the money, and I think they're going to be happy.
Abby Phillip is out front outside the White House tonight. Abby, you know, in that meeting, right, we're all told, okay, it was incredibly short. The president comes out and says, I said bye-bye. I mean, what exactly happened?
Well, it started off well enough with the president handing out Butterfingers and M&Ms to the people seated at the table. And after some back and forth over a number of different issues, it really quickly spiraled downhill. According to a couple of sources familiar with what happened in that meeting, there was a lengthy conversation between the two sides about the fact that they don't agree about what's happening at the border. The president at one point, according to multiple sources, talked about women being trafficked across the border with tape across their mouths. So there's no evidence that is happening quite the way that he described it. And so it was clear in that meeting that the two sides were really talking past each other about the details of what the crisis is and what the solution ought to be. The Democrats wanted to focus on ports of entry, where most of the drugs are being smuggled across the border through legal ports of entry. The president, though, was focused on his wall. And that's at the point when he asked Nancy Pelosi, if I open the government right now, will you, within the next 30 days, give me my wall? And at that point, Pelosi said no. Now, that's an offer that Democrats have rejected in the past, but it really, for the president, was the last straw. He got up from that table and he left the room. But what's interesting, Erin, is that after the president left the room, according to one source, the vice president stayed in the room and asked Democrats, are you going to put an offer on the table? According to the source, Democrats did not. Their position is very clear and very simple. They want the government reopened right now. They want to talk about all of this other stuff, all of the border security issues after the government has been reopened. So in other words, we are really right where we've been this entire time, 19 days and counting. There is no end in sight to this government shutdown.
All right, Abby, thank you very much. Although, of course, it's interesting you say, okay, well, we open the government and then we'll talk about those things, but they're not going to talk about the one thing he wants to talk about. I mean, obviously, you can see you got some serious problems here. Out front now, the Republican governor of Ohio, John Kasich, who also served in Congress during two shutdowns. So you've been through situations, of course, when we talk about time length here, we're about to hit a record, but you've been through similar. Look, the president gets up today, governor, walks out of that meeting, tweets, bye-bye. What do you say to that?
Well, Erin, look, I've been there when there's a lot of posturing. You know, I sat through many meetings. I can remember a couple that were really doozies, you know, and where we are now is there's nobody's willing to make an offer or a compromise. So let me propose one, okay? Why don't we take care of the DACA kids? They're not kids anymore, they're adults. And maybe some of these people who are facing deportation, the temporary people who are here, and give them a couple more bucks. You know, I mean, he wants 5.6 or whatever. I mean, everybody's for border security. You know, give them more than what you're offering. It's a nice little compromise. And then he gives you DACA or something like that. And then you get it solved. And at some point, they're all going to realize, okay, this doesn't make a lot of sense.
Right.
But I've been there. I've been in those rooms, Erin.
I mean, but, you know, I mean, probably not a room quite like this one. You know, the president of the United States just gets up and walks out, calls it a total waste of time, goes on Twitter to say bye-bye. I've never seen anything publicly like what we saw today from the president.
I agree with that. Well, I mean, he's a different sort. I'm just telling you, I've seen a lot of things. And it's just the problem is these folks are being hurt when you think about it, you know, particularly medical trials or people, the Wall Street can't function, you know, and all that. But you're going to have to come together. See, what I was a little pleased about, and I don't know where he is, you can't lock yourself in a corner. And the Democrats can't lock themselves in a corner. Yeah. So give them some more money. Bring some expert in who says, okay, we're not going to have a wall, but we're going to have more secure borders. And this is what it, and then let the expert figure out what it would look like. And
I mean, for his base, though, he's got to have a wall. I mean, you know, he's pinned his whole presidency now on a wall.
Well, and, you know, and the other side saying, we're not going to give you any wall, you know, and I mean, it's just, come on, it's both sides. You know what the people are saying across the country, if they're paying attention, and I'm not sure they are, they're like, come on, can you just do your job? That's what they're thinking. Yeah. And look, I mean, he's obstinate, they're obstinate. You know, I mean, I didn't actually see last night, but, you know, there he was. You know, I guess he read a speech he didn't want to read, and I saw it looked like Ma and Pa Kettle. It looked like they were, you know, they were so glum.
Referring
to
Nancy
and
Chuck.
Let's just get this done, Erin.
I mean, how much longer do you think this will go on? I mean, we're talking here now 19 days. You're about to set a record in American history for a shutdown. And you got both sides saying, my number's zero or my number's five. But there is no, I mean, how long does this go on?
Until both sides say enough. And that's how you get a compromise. When when you have a situation where both sides are just being obstinate, and, you know, if you're the president, you know, if I were president, I'd say, come on, let's not do this. Let's get through this, you know. But I've been experienced enough to know that you just cannot say, you know, it's my way or the highway. It doesn't work in life. Does it work, Erin, in life where you say,
Trump
okay, it's going to be
it's
my way
him.
Or
he's
no
in the
way.
White House.
I'll tell you,
it's
when
the only
that
way
happens,
he's ever operated.
I understand that. But, you know, when both sides realize it isn't working to their advantage, when both sides realize that, then there'll be a willingness to cut a deal. But until that happens, you know, the Democrats think they're winning, Trump thinks he's winning. Nobody knows who's going to win at the end. But what we hope is we get it done soon, we have border security, and then we move to a bigger immigration policy. Because all these problems can't be solved just at the border. It got to be solved in the neighboring countries where all these people are coming
from.
And
you point that out, of course, accurately, you know, but you end up, you know, you set the parameters of the debate and then all of a sudden it's as if everything outside, which may be much more significant, doesn't matter because the debate's in this little tiny, tiny space. I mean, you do talk about, though, when as you mentioned drug trials and, you know, I mentioned those as well, thousands of federal workers. I mean, there's 800,000 of them right now who aren't getting paid. President keeps focusing on, well, eventually they will, as if it's some paid vacation. Problem is, they got to pay their bills.
Yes.
I mean, you know, Speaker Pelosi spoke out about it today. I wanted to play it for you, Governor. Here she is.
The president seems to be insensitive to that. He thinks maybe they could just ask their father for more money, but they can't.
Now, that was a big slam on the president,
but
he
really
has been very lackadaisical about, you know, caring about them, at least showing any empathy.
Yeah, maybe he doesn't get that. Maybe he doesn't get that. But here's the thing. I mean, it's a real problem. If you don't make your mortgage payment or these clinical trials, you know, I read about that today. I mean, you're ready to go and do a clinical trial. You're holding your breath. Your family's holding your breath that you could be in a situation where your life could be saved or you could lose your life and they can't have the trial because things aren't open. I read that. I hope that's true. So there is a real problem here with keeping the government shut down. And frankly, nobody wants to see it. There are times when your principals say, okay, we cannot make a deal. It happens at times, but at the end of it, don't lock yourself into a corner. Put the people first, put the country first, because there's so much that needs to be done beyond just the border, beyond it. I mean, so let's see. I mean, I'd love to go down there and negotiate it. You know, I've been negotiating lots of things in my life, and it would be interesting to get them together. At some point, it will happen. But why don't we keep an eye on it, huh?
All right. Governor Kasich, I appreciate your time. Thank you so much.